How many of you know about this poem called Footprints? Footprints, most of you know it. It's about, you know, a poem that says, you know, I was walking with the Lord in my beach, and I saw two sets of footprints. My Lord was walking with me. And then, somewhere along the line, I only saw one set of footprints. And I realized that that set of footprints was the worst time in my life. I was walking alone, God. There was one set of footprints. When the worst time of my life came, Jesus, you abandoned me. Then she heard the voice of Jesus say, no, when you saw one set of footprints, it's that time when I came with you. You all know that, right? And that's the power of that footprints. But you know who wrote this poem? It's a woman from Canada called Margaret Fishback Powers. Most times you see this poem say anonymous. Actually, it's not anonymous. They know who the author is. Her name is Margaret Fishback Powers. She's a Christian. She's a Sunday school teacher in Canada. When she wrote it one day when she was walking with her fiancé along the beach, looked behind and saw two sets of footprints. That night she wrote the poem, which we all have come to love. But when she moved from Toronto to Vancouver in the 1950s, the truck that carried her goods lost that poem, lost one crate of her belonging, and it was a poem. And then 3 years after that, she saw this poem appear on posters and everywhere. And she began to take a lawsuit that this was her poem. Because by this time, this poem had reached millions, hundreds of millions of people, become a famous poem. And she took a lawsuit to instill her rights. Because if she wins the lawsuit, she will become a multi-millionaire. And then one day, God showed her in a dream where the original poem was. She had one copy of the poem hidden in the back of her photograph, wedding photograph. She opened up that wedding, the frame of the wedding photograph. That was the original poem, written in the 1950s. So when she saw it, this was proof that she was the original author. And so she told the lawyers, now we proceed full steam to reclaim my rights. And all my troubles will be over because she was not very well off. And I will become a millionaire. That night, God gave her a dream. And God said, people have come to love me as a result of this poem. They have loved me. They have seen what I can do for their lives. They have changed. This poem has changed life. If you bring this lawsuit, the whole world will associate this lawsuit with anger, bitterness, vindictiveness, resentment, jealousy, money, revenge. Drop the lawsuit. She woke up that morning, the next morning, and she told her lawyers, drop the lawsuit. So today, you will still see that poem, anonymous. But some of these publishers, they put her name down. Her name is Margaret Fishback Powers. She lived a life of total brokenness. That's why today, you enjoy this poem. What's the legacy that she will leave behind? If she won 100 million out of this, her legacy would only be for her lifetime, maybe for her kids. But because she lived the life of brokenness, her legacy will now be forever. That's what God wants to use you as leaders, that you will leave a legacy that lasts and have a fruitful legacy that really will outlast your life. Because God is attracted to brokenness, and brokenness is a journey, a choice that we must make. And it will never be complete until we see Jesus face to face. God bless you all.